Richard the First, Coeur de Lion, a name we English speak of with pride, though he lived not but 6 months in England from day he were born till he died. He spent most of his life fighting battles, dressed up in most rigid attire. His suits were all made by a blacksmith, and his underwear was knitted from wire. He married a lassie from Flanders, Berengaria is what they called her. But she turned out a good wife to Richard, in spite of having a name like that there. Because when he came home from his battles, she'd bandaged the wounds in his sconce. He, and if a snake was ever to bite him, well, she would suck out the poison at once. In his house there's a minstrel called Blondel, the one to amuse him like at the end of the day. And King had but one thing against him. He had not but one tune he could play. Anyway, he got so fed up in the finishes, he was so sick of hearing it played, he packed his spare suit on a wagon and went off and joined the crusade. He got fighting the moment he's landed, and the Saracen lads did their best, but he cut off their heads in such numbers, the local hatmakers lodged a protest. The Sultan, his name was Saladi, he thought he'd best try this business to stem. So he comes riding up to King Richard and said, "Oh, you mustn't do that there to them." And Richard said, "Oh, aye, and he'll stop me." Sultan said, "I will, and quick." So the king swiped his sword at the Sultan, who in turn swiped his skin to Dick. Well, they fought all that day without ceasing, until at last, well, each of them saw that, well, they were just a match for each other. So they chucked it and called it a draw. Well, as Richard rode home in the moonlight, he heard someone trying to croon. And there at the roadside stood Blondel, still singing his signature tune. Da-da-da-da. Anyway, he'd had to swim the last part of the journey. Well, his tune got him chucked overboard. He'd worked out his passage from England in search of his master and lord. Well, this meeting took Richard to panic. He set off and he didn't draw rein until he was well past the Austrian border and felt he could breathe safe again. He hid out in a neighbouring castle. Oh, but he'd not been there very long, when one night outside of his window stood Blondel, so singing that song. Well, this took the heart out of Richard. He came home dejected and low, and the very next fight he got into, he was killed without striking a blow. 9-8.